ओम शांति। हैप्पी दिवाली टू माय डिवाइन ब्रदर्स एंड सिस्टर्स एंड स्पेशल ग्रीटिंग्स ऑन दिस मोस्ट ऑस्पिशियस फेस्टिवल, फेस्टिवल ऑफ लाइट्स। Actually, we call it Diwali, Deepavali, Deep Mala. So this is connected with Deepak. So in English, in America, we say Festival of Lights. It's time when we honor the victory over evil. We celebrate Diwali with lots of light, lots of love, happiness and joy. Actually, Diwali is a religious festival. Hinduism believes that this festival, Hinduism, is considered the festival of fast. Many keep fast on Diwali also. So festival of fast, festival of feast, and festival of lights. Because each and every festival, Indian festival, we light a Deepak. But especially on Diwali, we light many, many Deepaks. So it becomes a rosary of Deepak. And in Hinduism, there are so many festivals. And the beauty is, all the festivals are interconnected. It has a great meaning behind the festival. Just like last month we celebrated Dashahara, right? And Hinduism believes that until we celebrate Dashahara, we can't celebrate Deepavali. Why? Do you also believe that?
Yes.
So first we will see, what is Dashahara? What do we do on Dashahara? People create effigy of Ravan and burn it in happiness. Dashahara. Das means 10, hara means defeated. So it marks the defeat of Ravan by Lord Rama. Who was Ravan? People think Ravan had 10 heads. And the most important thing, if you cut one head, if you chop one, it can emerge again. Is it possible? Tell me. Is it possible? Human head, if you chop, can it emerge again? No. Physically, no. It won't be possible. So who is Ravan? The 10 heads of Ravan are the symbol of 10 types of negativities, 10 types of vices, and they are here in our mind. So Ravan is not one person. Ravan is our vices. They have entered in our mind, not just sitting quietly, no, is controlling us, ruling our mind, is spoiling our character. Because of anger, greed, ego, what type of actions we perform, that is called karam bhog. Then we have to take medicine. Medicine, sin. I always wonder the names of medicine. Soframycin, Tobramycin, Anacin, Anicacin, Gentamicin, Mycin. Mycin. All about sin. Have you thought why medicine tablets come in the package of 10? Well, it all started with Ravan getting big headache. 10 heads is not a small thing. Sin. So, spoiling our character, even against our wish, we don't want, but has entered in. So, literal sense of Ravan is rulane wala. He makes us cry. So, Ravan actually means our inner weakness. To overcome our inner weakness, we need inner strength. So before celebrating Dashahara, what do we celebrate? Navratra. Right? 9 days, people invoke Shaktis. They invoke goddesses of power. Durga ji means Durguno ko nash karne wala. Durguno ko nash karne wali, the one who destroys Durgun, weaknesses. So 9 days we invoke Durga ji, we worship Durga ji, and then we are equipped with inner power. Then very next day, 10th day, that is Dashahara. We call Dashahara Vijayadashmi also. Vijayadashmi means getting victory over 10. Now, today we are celebrating Diwali, right? Question is, have you finished Ravan? I'm not talking about Ravan whose effigy we burn. Yeah, that is burned. We have finished. But I am talking about the real Ravan, which is sitting in. Ravan's statue of effigy, we never keep in our home. We put in the field and we burn it, finish it. Others, gods, deities, Sri Ram, Sri Krishna's, or Durga ji's, Lakshmi ji's, their photo frame or idol, murti, we keep in our home. So what is the purpose of keeping them in our home? Please remember. Why do we keep their photos, their idols in our home? When we see them, we get inspired. Right? We can learn something good. So we always keep. Ravans nobody keeps. Now, today you are getting one thing free. There are two types of idols. One is Sri Ramji's, who is the Maryada Purushottam, and other is Ravan's idol. You can get free one, but with the condition of keeping always in your home. Which one you going to choose? Tell me. Definitely Ram's. Okay. Now if you are told that Ram's idol is 100-pound brass, please pay attention because it's dealing. Ram's idol is 100 pound of brass and Ravan's is 100 pound gold. Which one you would choose?
Gold.
Scenario is little different now. Think about which one you would choose?
Gold.
Suppose I choose Ravan's because of 100 pound gold and I take in my home. Condition is I have to keep in my home constantly, always. What inspirations I will get from Ravan's idol?
To get more gold.
How goes Ravan? What is his personality? Not good responses coming. He was deceitful. Actually, deceitful is a package. There are many other things are in that package. Anger, greed, show off, many different things, negative things. So what inspiration I will get from him? Not good. What is the goal of our life? Being happy? Goal is this, na? Being peaceful? So if I choose Ravan's idol because of the gold, what happens? I compromise myself with my values. If I choose gold rather than my values, what happens? Degradation begins. I can get gold very easily in this Iron Age. I tell you the truth. But if I pay full attention towards my goal, gold will follow me automatically. In Olympics, what happens? There are many players, but one gets gold medal. What is the difference between other players and the one who gets gold medal? What is the difference between these two types? The one who gets gold medal pays full attention towards his goal. And then gold follows, na? Gets gold medal, na? Same way, if I forget my goal, I choose gold, I can have a 4 necklaces of gold, but inside I will not be happy. I will not be peaceful. These necklaces, gold necklaces, can't wipe my tears, can't remove my sorrow. What is happening in this world today? What is happening? You know more than me. What's the condition of our mind? Ravan has entered us. We have a fighting within. There is a fighting with our goodness, our own goodness, and evil is happening. Yesterday I got one message on WhatsApp about 4 yugas which are widely accepted in Hinduism. Satyug, Treta Yug, Dwapar Yug, Kali Yug. Golden Age, Silver Age, Copper Age, Iron Age. So in Satyug there is fight between 2 worlds, Devlok and Asurlok. Asurlok being an evil is different world. In Treta Yuga, Silver Age, there is a fight between Sri Ram and Ravan. Both rulers are from different countries. In Dwapar Yuga, in Copper Age, there is fight between Kaurav and Pandav. Both evil and good from the same home. See the evil getting closer, closer, closer. For example, from different world, Asurlok, Devalok, to different countries came little closer, na? And from the same home. So, in Kali Yuga, tell me, where is the evil? Inside of us. There is constant battling here. Good and evil. Have you noticed that? We must have experienced that. Once I defeat that evil which is sitting here, that will be real Dashahara. And after celebrating Dashahara, real Diwali comes. How one after another festival comes, and it has a great meaning behind that. So Diwali is the sign of newness. Diwali is a sign of happiness. Diwali is a sign of prosperity. So today, this is the darkest period in the world. God, supreme power, supreme light has come to ignite the light within us.